violation of Title 40 of the United States Code, so I please ask you to please jump down on the First Street sidewalk. We need to see you down there.
We believe that we are not. We will step to the sidewalk, but we believe we are not in
violation of the fine.
We might take it to the Supreme Court, actually. This is a pop culture reference.
It's not a protest. You need to demonstrate on the sidewalk. You do your walking, do your pictures, everything down here, okay?
The actual risk would be a pandemic if people walk around without masks.
I wonder if Amy Coney Barrett would recuse herself from that case.
Right now, we are still in violation of Title 40 United States Code, Section 6135, as well as Regulation 7.
We believe you would have quite a lot of difficulty enforcing that. We're not holding any signs or anything.
Go ahead, step down.
We will enforce it if we need to. I'd rather not.
We would rather not.
I appreciate you.
We do not believe that.
Thank you very much. Step to the sidewalk, please. Thank you.
And all the way down.
Thank
you very much. All right. Seven. Can somebody send us some pictures?
We are here today because we do not believe that we should be rushing through a Supreme Court confirmation while many people in this country are actually in the process of voting. This is not just a few days before the election. This is actually in the midst of the election. We believe that Trump having another confirmed Supreme Court justice is just his way at a last-ditch power grab, because he knows that he's going to lose the election, and he wants to bring it before the Supreme Court, and he wants the Supreme Court justices to be indebted to him. We also know that specifically any nominee from Donald Trump has agreed that the Affordable Care Act is unconstitutional and will probably rule as such when the Affordable Care Act oral argument is heard on November 10th. And tens of millions of people in our country rely on the Affordable Care Act to get their health care. And President Trump has no alternative plan. It is merely an attempt to strip away health care for tens of millions of people in this country in the midst of a pandemic.
Speaking of the pandemic, I saw one of the signs was talking about they haven't voted on relief, but they're looking to vote really quickly on a Supreme Court justice. Do you want to tell me about that issue?
Yeah, exactly. The House Democrats, the House of Representatives have brought over a plan to provide relief to everyday folks, to prevent evictions, to get food on the table, to help alleviate some of the suffering that's been incurred because of COVID. Tens of millions of people have become unemployed and therefore have lost their employer-based health insurance. And we need actual money right now. We need real relief to get into the pockets of real people. And the Senate Democrats, the senators, the Republicans in the Senate have just refused to do anything to provide any kind of relief to people. So Mitch McConnell has stopped, looking at any of the bills. He's left us with nothing for months upon months. And so we're saying no SCOTUS before stimulus. We need money right now. Tomorrow, it's October 1st, today. It's a day when, millions more people in this country will face eviction. And we're calling on the Senate Democrat, on the Senate Republicans, that if they want to do something, they should vote on giving us real relief.
All right, I have to get on the leave,
you ladies.
Yeah, me too.